Hello guys, welcome to Code with BK. So in this video, I'm going to solve question 3 of ISC 2018 Computer Science Theory paper. So this is the question in front of me, give it a reading. Okay, so you are given this method, this is the method that is given, and you are given 5 question marks that you need to fill so that this method works correctly. And this method is supposed to check if an integer value is palindrome or not. So an integer value is palindrome if the reverse of that integer is exactly equal to the original integer. So these are the answers, and this video is divided into 2 parts. In the first part, I'm going to explain how I arrived to these answers, and in the next part, I'm going to run this method on these test cases and check if my answer was correct or not. Okay. So you should all obviously read the complete question before you start, because it clearly says that this function does not use the modulus operator to extract the digit. So this is something different from what you usually do when you find the reverse of a number. Okay, so the first thing is rev. Okay, and if you look through to the function, in the final steps it says if rev is equals to n return true, else return false. So this clearly tells that rev is supposed to store the reverse of the original number. And since we are calculating and building up the value of rev in this while loop, so rev has to start with 0. Okay, so that's why 1 is 0. Okay, we come down to this next line, 970 is num is equals to n, and then we have the while loop for num is greater than 0. So the question is, why not directly use the value of n? That is because if you directly use the value of n becomes 0 after this while loop, so you will not have the original value of n to compare with the new reverse value. That's why the value of n is left as it is, and calculations are done on num, which is a copy of value of n. Okay, so you first have f is equals to num by 10. So according to this statement, f will be storing the value by after removing the last unit digits of the value num. For example, if num is equals to 256, okay, so num by 10 is equals to 256 by 10 is equals to 25. Okay, so you are removing, which is, it implies removing 6 from the value 256, which is removing the last digit from the given value num. Okay, so there is no blank that we need to fill here. Okay, then in this line, s is equals to question mark. So using just these 2 lines, I cannot make out what s is, so I'll move to the next line. Okay, so now in digit is equals to num minus 3. Okay, now this is very helpful. So digit, that is the last digit that is to be extracted, is num minus some value. So if we check out our example, we need to find 6 using the value of num. So how do you get 6? How do you get 6 from 256? You do 256 minus 250 is equals to 6. Okay, so you have num, which is the original value, which is 256, and you subtract 3 from it, and 3 is 250. So how do you get to 250? You do 25 into 10, and that is where s comes into play. So s is equals to f into 10. Okay, and then digit is equals to num minus s. So what is basically happening, you need to get 6 out of 256. So dividing it by 10, you are getting 25, and then you are multiplying 25 into 10. So you get 250. So 256 minus 250 will give you the last digit, and this is valid for any value. For example, if you take 78, right? If you take 78, so the last digit will be 8, you will get 7 as a value in F, and in S you will get 7 into 10, which is 70. So you subtract 70 from 78, you get 8. Okay, and then we come to this part. So if you have done this problem of getting the reverse of a digit before, you understand, you will clearly understand what this is. And if you have not done this before, it might be a little tricky for you to find it out, because this is a standard way of developing a number using digits. So that's why 4 is equals to rev into 10. Okay, and finally we have number is equals to 5. So this is removing the last digit that we have extracted. So how do you remove 6 from 256? You divide it by 10, you divide the value by 10 and store it back into num. So num is equals to num by is equals to 10, which is equals to num by 10, which is equals to, also which is equals to num by 10. So we have, it implies we have 256 equals to 256 by 10 equals to 25. So 6 is removed from 25 and stored back into num, and then the loop repeats again. So that is why we have 5 as num. So this was the solution. Let me just quickly copy this and just check it out. So I'll copy this, I'll comment this, I'll uncomment this, I'll paste the solution here, give it a tab, okay, and this is static so that it is directly accessible from the main, and I need to set this value. Rev is equals to 0 equals to f into 10, num is equals to num minus s, digit is equals to num minus s equals to ref into 10 and 5 is 10. Okay, so everything looks fine here. Okay, let me just quickly compile and check Java C. Okay, it is all okay, and then it is Java question 3. Oh, some different question, sorry. So Java ISC 2018, it is question 3 theory. Okay, so is 121 palindrome is true, 0 palindrome is true, 25 palindrome is false, 370 and 1. Okay, so this was the answer, and this was to explain you how do you get to this answer. So I hope this video was helpful. Please do like this video and subscribe to my channel for more such videos. Thank you for watching.